Are you trying to absolutely crush your competition with the EBLC RAM? Are you watching other people dominate the battlefield with the RAM and you get in it and you die and it's not fun? I'm here to help you. I'm going to talk about my loadout in the RAM, the kind of tips and tricks I use on the battlefield quite a bit in most of my vehicles. Some of them will be an overlap of some other vehicles I've done a review to try to help you get better. We are here to help you get better in the vehicles, in the armor. So let's get into it. So starting in the loadout section, primary weapon, driver's seat, I always, almost always run the 40 millimeter cannon. One, I'm very comfortable with 40 millimeter cannon because I run that also on the Wildcat. So the trajectory, the flight path, all that stuff, I'm quite familiar with that and it's comfortable for me. I'm pretty good at driving and shooting with this round as well. The howitzer obviously packs a lot more punch, but has quite an arc to it. Haven't totally figured it out. I probably could figure it out if I used it more, but I like the faster shot time. I like the reload speed on the 40 millimeter cannon. The howitzer, if you miss your shot, you're kind of SOL a bit. But obviously you don't have to hit as many shots as you do with the 40 millimeter cannon. So if you're running by yourself and you're running up against a lot of armor, you may want to run the howitzer because you may not have backup. I usually try to have a gunner, which is why I run the cannon, because I usually have backup against other armor. Down here, a secondary weapon, always running the HMG. I run the HMG actually in so many vehicles. If you have a thermal version of this too, that is elite. Some of the new updates brought that to vehicles with thermal scope on the HMG, but absolutely love this. It is great for personnel, great backup. So hit obviously all your vehicles with the 40 millimeter cannon and then back it up with the HMG. Equipment slot. If you've seen some of my other reviews of vehicles or some of my help tips for vehicles, thermal smoke package all day long. It breaks locks. It's a great screen, helps you get out of dodge if you need to. But I love not having to worry about aircraft dropping the nukes on me from above for the air-to-ground missiles, so I love the thermal smoke. Pretty much always run repair system, active protection system. I see tons of people run. I would say active protection system is more of an offensive approach to these two. Repair system is more of a defensive. I'm probably more of a defensive player. I do not sit in spawn, that is not me, but I like to play angles, keep good spacing, move around the battlefield, try to move around smartly, which is why I normally use the repair system. Active protection is great. It blocks incoming, but I also don't ever want to have to hop out and repair my own ride. So that's why I use the repair system. And then insert beacon. This is the reason this vehicle is one of the greatest. This is one of the greatest supports to your team, is having the team insertion beacon. So if you are running the RAM and you are not strategically placing the team insertion beacon, what I mean by that is putting it where it can't get shot, first of all. Hide it behind a rock, put it in a creek, put it somewhere where the enemy can't see it, or other vehicles can't see it, or it can't get hacked. Put it somewhere strategic, close to an objective, or integrate spawn point. Don't leave people just get absolutely crucified when they come out of the insertion beacon. Put it in a smart spot. Make sure it stays alive as long as it can, because it does have a reload cycle, but use this team insertion beacon. I absolutely love this. You get tons of free points. It makes a cool little sound like, bleep. I love it. Absolutely love team insertion. Use it, be an amazing team member, and take full advantage of the insertion beacon, because you can turn a game around if you have a good RAM player who's using the beacon correctly. So that is my driver's seat, 40 millimeter cannon, HMG, thermal smoke, repair. Let's go to weapon station. Weapon station here, right now, don't have all the choices. When I get HMG thermal, I will run that. I normally run HMG here. This one I was just using to check something out with a gunner I had last night. But once again here, I run HMG and then I will run HMG thermal. So if you think about it, I'm running anti-personnel in the weapon station, which I'll explain why. So I have anti-personnel here. I also have anti-personnel backup with my driver's seat. And then I can use the 40 millimeter cannon against armor or aircraft if I need to. Weapon station two, easy choices. You can't screw this one up. You have these two. The key to this, so even if you only have one other person with you and it is a friend and you can communicate, you know what? I'm going to save that. These are my two options. I'm going to save that for when we get it to actually battlefield how to's and how to stay alive longer. So really, really easy, really simple weapon station two. Weapon pod, 60 millimeter flak. If this is available, always run the 60 millimeter flak pod. It's available this, it's available in the Wildcat, it's available in some vehicles, always run it. It is the greatest weapon, I believe, as a support gun in all of the vehicles, so don't ever not choose this. If you don't have it, obviously start with the canister pod, but as soon as you get the flak, put it on, because it's got a pretty much a laser. It doesn't have a lot of drop. I believe they nerfed it. It doesn't seem like it has enough as much splash. It's good against vehicles, all vehicles, and great against personnel as well. So love the 60mm flak. So those are what I'm running. The main thing you want to remember when you're running vehicles is you want to have a diverse weapon set. You want to be able to take out all the things that are going to be coming at you, whether that's personnel, whether that's land vehicles, whether that's air vehicles. You want to have options to take them out. So here, 40mm, good against personnel, good against vehicles. HMG, great against personnel. Weapon station, HMG, HMG thermal, great against personnel. Okay, I'm covered on personnel. Weapon station, obviously you have both options here to take out, which is amazing. Land or air. And then your weapon pod, this thing is also good at everything. Canister pod, great against personnel. You're probably going to be a little bit light on the, if you have to run the shot pod, I'd probably come back here to driver and go howitzer if you have it, because you're going to need more power against the actual other vehicles. So that is that. So let's get into how I play with the RAM. One, the RAM can be quite aggressive because it has so much speed. It's not a giant slow toaster box, kind of like the MAV or anything like that. You can be aggressive with the MAV as well because it's just such a brute and can take such a beating. But the RAM's really good at being agile. You want to make sure you're using the beacon like we talked about. But a couple of things that I really focus on. If you, it's just you as the driver, you don't have a whole lot of choice, but you can switch between seats. Don't forget that if you're alone, you can use the different seats to jump between to help you out of a sticky situation. But you got to be careful with that and realize what's around you and what's in your surroundings. If you have another gunner that you're able to speak to, let them know through communication what we're coming up against if they're not seeing it. So if we're driving around and I just have one of my buddies with me and it's just him and I will say, hey, coming up on a tank. He will jump to weapon station two. He'll switch to AT missile and we will take on the tank or the armor that we're going up against. Or I'll say, hey, coming up, condor above us, dropping people off at whatever point. And then they will jump into the weapon station two and go to AA missile and then take shots on the condor while I'm also taking care of ground. So use that communication if you are talking to your gunner, and then after they make a couple shots or we do take out the armor or air, they will switch back to the 60mm flak, because this weapon is so good against personnel as well. As it's the best all-around gun, I think, in the gunner seats. So make sure you're communicating. If you do have a helper or you have a friend that's playing with you, let them know and let them jump around seats. It actually works out really well and they have multiple options, especially because of your diverse weapon choice. So make sure you do give that. One thing I say about all the vehicles, the one thing you always want to do is never sit still. Never sit still with a vehicle, because you are absolutely going to get C5'd, AT mined. People are going to jump out of planes to drop on top of you. I mean, look at all the clips all over online, on Twitter, on YouTube, and all that is crazy stuff. And a lot of that time, people sitting still. So don't sit still. You will get killed so much faster if you do. Keep moving. Get good at shooting and driving at the same time. It will make an absolute difference. You'll stay alive a lot longer. The other thing I will say with the RAM, it is more of a lighter vehicle. I like to move with the flow of the battle of my teammates. The RAM can go off by itself because it has so much pace. Just be careful with that. If you're surrounded by your friendlies, one, it'll be more people to repair you. Two, it's more people pulling aggro. Not everybody will be focused on you, and that you won't have 100 recoilless coming at you at the same time. Some of the other vehicles will be focusing on personnel as well. You won't be as alone. If you were off on your own point, which you can do with the RAM, just be careful, be cautious, make sure you're looking around and taking a look at your surroundings. So those are my loadouts. Those are my tips for running the RAM and staying alive longer and getting lots of kills. I am a pretty experienced battlefield vehicle user. I usually have very good games with high kill counts and stay alive for a pretty long time, but I've also been playing it for quite a while. So if you have any questions or you need any additional help or tips, please let them down below and I will help out as much as I can. But I think that's it, and we will catch you on the next one.